That faggot place needs to fucking die.
God damn it, Cartman, you are not gonna kill Blaze. Shut the fuck up, you Jewish cunt. You are not gonna stop me. I will not let you do it. Fuck off. It's time to finally kill that faggot Blaze the movie fag.
Where the hell am I? That's exactly where you are. Hell. No, I mean seriously. Yes. Also, Death wants to talk to you. I will give you credit for one thing. You only died 2 times this year, so you are no longer wasting my time. But there is something you need to understand. What is it? You are now dead, which means your YouTube career is over, but since you were watching a movie, I will let you do the movie review of the movie you were watching. But accept the fact that it's your final review. But the problem is, I died during the middle of the movie. No problem, there is a movie theater in hell. Don't forget to say goodbye in the review. Alright then, thanks. I just hope you are dead for good this time. Hey guys, what's up? This is Blaze the Movie Fan and it's time for another movie review. This time I will be reviewing Rogue One. Now at first when I saw the trailers, I wasn't really excited. I mean, I was looking forward to the movie, but I wasn't exactly excited. And Chris Stockman's review made me even less excited. Now don't get me wrong, it does not mean that I thought the movie was gonna suck. Far from it. It just means that I wasn't especially excited for the movie. The main reason why I wasn't very excited about the movie is because it's a fucking spin-off. And usually spin-offs turn out shitty. But I'm glad to say that I am pleasantly surprised. Is this movie as good as The Empire Strikes Back or any of the movies in the original trilogy? Or even The Force Awakens? Hell no, not even close. These movies that I mentioned are far fucking better than this movie. But I gotta say though that I like this movie. The first praise I can give this movie is the fact that it's different from most other Star Wars movies. What do I mean by that? Well, I'm gonna start by talking about the protagonist of the movie, Lynn Erso, played by Felicity Jones. Now, Lane is a very different character from any of the protagonists in the original trilogy, The Force Awakens. The main thing that makes her very different is the fact that she isn't connected to anybody who is in power. What I mean by that is that she's not a friend or a relative to the Queen or the Emperor. And you know what? That's a breath of fresh air. Another thing to note about her is the fact that she is the most sympathetic Star Wars character. That doesn't mean that I think that she is the best, far from it. In fact, I like most of the characters in the other Star Wars movies more. The others that I mentioned earlier on in the video, I mean. But anyway, she has a depressing backstory, and at the top of that, she is very fucking brave and never gives up. And you know what? That's very fucking awesome. She does what she feels is right. But anyway, her father was taken away from her at a very early age, and she had to hide so they wouldn't get her too. Just thinking about that beginning of the movie makes me fucking cry. Now the next character of the movie that I would like to talk about is K2CO, played by Alan Tudyk. I gotta say that this robot is the best robot I've seen in any Star Wars movie, period. He is much better than that annoying cunt in the original trilogy. You know, that golden robot. Yeah, as much as I love the original trilogy, that is one aspect of it that I don't like. But anyway, back to talk about on this movie. The main thing that makes him so fucking awesome is the fact that he is extremely rational and everything that he says makes sense. And the thing about it is, he is more than just someone who gives some helpful advice. He's also a great pilot, is great at fights. And yeah, everything about this robot is so fucking awesome. And that robot is the best part about the movie, hands down. The third and final character of the movie that I wrote to talk about is Grand Moff Tarkin, played by Guy Henry. The actor who played that character in the original trilogy is now dead. So how the hell do the people manage to make that character come back in this movie? I don't know how the hell they did it, but he looks almost fucking identical to the guy in the original trilogy. Not only that, he also sounds almost exactly the fucking same. How the hell did they accomplish that? I don't know. But anyway, in this movie, he is given more depth. Because in the original trilogy, he wasn't really given a lot of depth. But in this movie, he is the main villain. And it really fucking shows. Now, of course, he worked for the bad guys. And I really fucking like him a lot. He's much better in this movie than he is in any other Star Wars movie, that's for sure. Now, of course, I don't need to tell you that the technical aspects of the movie are fucking awesome, because that's just stating the motherfucking obvious, as this is a blockbuster after all, and you would expect that. But there is one thing that makes this movie stand out from other Star Wars movies that I gotta talk about. This movie is a lot more fucking brutal and has a lot more fucking action than the other Star Wars movies. And by the other Star Wars movies, I am talking about all of them, including the shitty prequels. And the fact that the movie is so brutal is exactly what makes it so fucking awesome. Of course, there is no blood or anything like that. But it is very brutal though. And what makes this movie especially fucking awesome is the fact that I can't tell that the people I'm supposed to root for are in real fucking danger. There's no sugarcoating it or anything like that. There is no the protagonist always wins cliche. Everybody in this movie has such a high possibility to fucking die. Having said that, there is one thing about this movie that holds it back a bit. And that's the fact that Darth Vader only appears for less than 15 fucking minutes in the movie. Now, I would be okay with it and accept it if it wasn't for one thing. Darth Vader is in the fucking trailers! I mean, seriously, if he's only gonna appear for less than 15 minutes in the movie, don't show him in the fucking trailers. That just makes the trailer misleading, and I find misleading trailers to be fucking disgusting. And yes, that trailer with Darth Vader was misleading because it implied that he was gonna be a major character of the movie. He's fucking not. With that minor rant out of the way, it's time for my overall thoughts. This, in my opinion, is the fifth best Star Wars movie. Because I like the original trilogy and The Force Awakens more. But that's definitely not a bad thing, because this movie is fucking awesome. I really love how different it is from most other Star Wars movies. So you know what? I'm gonna give this movie the rating 2 thumbs up. Normally I end the video by saying thank you for watching and have a great day, but since I'm dead, I'm in hell, and I was told that I was only allowed to review one more movie. So let me just end this video by saying this. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.
Well, now that I'm dead, there is nothing to do, is there? Don't be so sure, you can still have fun here in hell. We rarely have humans here. Trust me, we will become good friends. Alright, great. Now what the hell is happening?
Where the hell am I? You are lucky to be alive. You are one of the few people who survived the Kringle Bio massacre. Should I go back to work? Hell no, you are in no
condition to be a postman. You need to take weeks off.
Not necessarily. I can heal a place in no time at all.
Well, you're lucky to have a Pokemon that has healing abilities. Now you can go back home. In fact, I can drive you there if you want.
Fucking awesome!
What? Blaze is still alive? God motherfucking damn it! What do I have to do to kill that fucking fair god?